Hello lads, welcome back to good old Lustria, where we are commencing our epic Corsair conquest with this mad cunt, Lucre Fellheart. And I thought to aware you of the fact that I just did my daily stretches, and if you haven't seen my daily stretching video yet, you can find it on the channel. Definitely recommended to stretch a bit each day, and especially if you are sedentary, if you sit down a lot during your day, it's very important that you give your body some mobility work, because we're not suited to sit still so much. So if you're watching this now and if you have been sitting still a lot, I definitely encourage you to not sit in a chair, but to sit down in a squat instead. So try that out, and let's get into the episode. So last time, obviously, we had a glorious battle in here with Lucre, where he defeated the High Elf antagonists, and we have leveled. Now what I want to do, obviously, here is I want to get a Draftmaster, so we will level one of these, because we need to spend 4 skill points in the previous group. So we're gonna go with that, because casualties captured post-battle, plus 25%, obviously great, since we're such an economy dependent on slaves, and it's always good with some extra income from post-battle. So without further ado, let's attack these lads. And this means the balance of power, and this is very much enough in our favor, so I don't really need to take that manually. I can just out-resolve it. Then slay this. Boom, and we have leveled yet again. And now we just need one more level here to get the Draftmaster. And public order is good enough, but ultimately not something that will be very useful. Serve or die, same thing there. It's a bit cheaper recruitment, but quality over quantity, especially for this particular army. So we're gonna go with Infamous Raider. So some more income from raiding, looting and sacking. It sounds good. And then we're gonna have a little look here at what the crack is in regards to his things. So a talisman, boom, we'll take it back from the other lord. The Hydra banner, same thing there. The blood banner. So we're basically taking back all of our nice things from the other lord, including our harem keeper. It's a vital component in a dark elf lord's retinue. By the cruel seas. So yeah, we're gonna retake this. Not even a fight, and obviously since it's our guys, we're just gonna occupy, so we're not gonna do anything silly such as loot or occupy or sack. So we're just gonna occupy. Boom. There we are. And we're not gonna upgrade any of these, because we're gonna save the population surplus to bloat max our capital here, so this gets to the highest possible level. We can also build something fun here. 2000. Boom. It's a good deal, so we can create some Reaper bolt throwers. Same thing here. Quite expensive, but it is worth it for the greater good. So yeah, let's take the turn. And after we've taken the turn, we're obviously gonna continue down to take the last settlement of this particular region, so we can initiate an edict that will bolster all of the settlements in the region. And after that, we can finally take the High Elf Citadel. I think this is a reasonable course of action. And we gain that because we spent multiple turns in a settlement with low public order. Right, that's good stuff. And not really much to do here, but to reconquer this place. Sacrifice them to Mathlan. I'm not gonna take this battle, because as you can see, it's the balance of power is quite much in our favor. We will let's give these two banners to some of our lads there for the lols. Same thing here, since it's our guys, we're gonna occupy. And we have unlocked a regiment of renown, the Hellebronnai Dread Spears. Okay. Sickening. And now we can obviously initiate an edict, and we're gonna go with increase slave production quota. Income from slaves plus 10% and growth plus 20. So that's obviously very good, since we will try to increase our growth as much as possible all the time. So yeah, great. And our man here is leveled, so boom, Draftmaster. Absolutely epic. And we can build some fun things as well in Chupaiotl. Worst pronunciation ever, but anyway. So what we can do is slave pens is something fun we can build. Not particularly fun though. I don't suppose it's particularly fun being a slave, but the dark elves are this way. It's just how it is. So we're gonna go with that, and also Black Roads. Can of course do that, and then we'll see. Yeah, that's a reasonable course of action. Indeed. And we'll take the turn. Right, there we are. Ready for duty, Jorian. I don't know if I will re-recruit her. It would actually be useful enough to have an additional lord, so that we can take these lads once and for all, because I don't know if we could actually take this settlement with just one lord, because they have their quite advanced garrison there. So let's initiate some sort of aggression, and what I will do in order to make this episode a bit more concise, I will take a few turns until we have come to a more action-oriented place in the campaign. So I'm just gonna research exploit feuds. Boom. Public order, always nice to have, and then we're good to go. So yeah, be right back. Alright, so I've taken a few turns, and this army of Melvin has stationed himself outside of Kayax, and he might take that. However, what we could do in return is to simply swoop in to take the Citadel of Dusk, because they have a weak enough army, I suppose. Well, not including their Citadel army, but we're gonna try that, and we obviously have our Admiral to back us up there, so we're gonna do that and see what happens. Then we have our Jorian here. We'll try to stave off the public order a bit at least, but let's take a turn and see what the crack is. So anyway, comment below what you have trained or what you will train. It's always a fun thing reading through, and give each other a thumbs up if you see someone has commenced a good solid session, so that we get the right kind of comments getting the most likes. So anyway, they have landed here, and I suppose they will take KX, and we will also have a rebellion on our hands, but we might actually finally have the Citadel of Dusk in our hands though, so might be worth it. We will figure out. Okay, we have stumbled upon Black Dragon Egg. A Black Dragon Egg appears to have been rolled from its nest to lay before you. Malekith will surely desire such a thing, but if you were to take it, just think of the power that could be yours to command. loyalty plus one, loyalty minus one, and a massive bonus experience. But loyalty is everything. Even in gaming, loyalty is everything. So, boom, hand it over. Now, what I am thinking about is if we'd like to station this guy here, if he can be. He can reinforce. No, he can't directly, but we still have our magic there. Okay, this could be a cool battle that we will definitely take. Yeah, let's get into it. Boom. Right, so as you can see, we have two Reaper Bolt Throwers and yeah, some missile units at least. Quite a bit of melee as well, and then a good amount of Courser handbows. We don't have any flying, we don't have any cavalry, not any monsters, and not any magic. So I don't think they have any magic either, so that is all good then. But they do have a lot of Lord and Sea God, and they are at rank 2. They have two of these chevrons, and we have three. So quite experienced army of Loker Fellheart here. They've been battle hardened over the last while in the Lustrian jungle. Alright, we are in the battle. And I don't suppose there is all too much to wait for. We'll group this. One, two, and I suppose this will be the third group. Yeah, let's start the battle and see what is up. I usually go with multi-shot round, especially against infantry. They also have a Eagle Claw Bolt Thrower there. Boom, and it's starting already. Now I obviously want to focus on their Lord and Sea Guard, just because that's such a strong unit, and they are, yeah, they're firing back at us. Inevitable that we will take these casualties. So, but anyway, I would rather that they take the casualties, since these are strong units and they're also their leveled ones. And we have some fun magic things. And I hope that they stand still there so we get in the flail there. Let's see. Boom. Yes. Very good indeed. So that's almost broken, which means that we can target the next one. Aha, they are advancing. So I will have to wait with these, because I don't want them to run away from it and miss it. So, yeah. Now, let us see. Okay, boom, they are getting absolutely wrecked there. There's their general, Jinquella, and she will have to face off against Luker here. So I'm gonna try to get him into a good position to do that. And I suppose he's in a good position already to do that. What we can do is actually advance a bit. Alright, I didn't actually take away skirmish mode on these lads, so that will have to be done. Okay, Luker, you know what to do. Get at him, boys. Aha, that's actually a noble as well. Let's see now. Aha, I get stuck there anyway. Dreaded Duelist. Now, let us see. We have more ship abilities there. We're just gonna keep bombarding them. And okay, we are... I have been distracted by other things. We need to advance our battle line here. Definitely is the only reasonable course of action. And they had an eagle of superior morals. I don't know where he went though, but I'm sure he is here somewhere. Illuminating dark elves. Ah, there he is. He is about to illuminate the Lukir. Let's see. Let's spectate this epic battle. Boom. I almost feel bad for the eagle. I'm sure most of you who are watching this are also friends of animals. So then you don't particularly enjoy the sight of animals being hurt. But it is what it is. The eagle, he could have joined our righteous cause, but he chose to stand with the high elves. Well, to be perfectly honest, I don't particularly enjoy killing high elves either. Since they are an archetype of humanity that is fair and kind and just. Also, remind me to make my elf video, which I've been saying that I should do for ages now. Cool, there we go. Victory. Victory for Malekith. So anyway, the elf video is where I will explain a bit why I sometimes refer to myself as an elf, and that's obviously an elf in the archetype sense. But yeah, separate video about that coming in the coming week, I suppose. I don't see any reason to delay doing that. The Kraken Lord always wins. Loot gained 3,000. Boom. Now, what we could do? We can loot and occupy. But, yeah, no, as I said, I don't... there is the possibility that they have other eagles of superior morals, and we don't want them to get hurt, so we're just gonna occupy. And we're gonna dedicate it to Mathlan. So yeah, Citadel of Dusk, finally ours. That feels good. Feels good indeed. So what we must do then is to get to this place, and that can be a bit hard, but I suppose that can be a nice next step for this campaign in all actuality. So what we're gonna do is increase the slave market, despite me just having confessed that it might be immoral to keep slaves, but it has to be done. It has to be done, at least in this situation. So I will simply do like this. I will level Lukir. And we have a lot of fun things here that we can do. We want to get to this, because that's a really good thing. We have a lot of cool things here too. Patriarch of the Fellharch, but these kind of things are not available quite yet. Now, what we could do though is simply to, I suppose, none of these are really that inspiring. We're gonna go with something fun here instead. Inspiring presence, because we're gonna do some more battles. Anyway, thank you for watching. XXO, boom.